They've been called the suburb's best kept dance secret, and now this female and minority-led premier ballet has launched its 11th season. Ballet 5-8 plans to bring audiences breathtaking performances that showcase their artistry, innovation, and elegance. And joining us now to tell us more about the upcoming season is the artistic director and resident choreographer, Juliana Rudio Slager. Welcome!
Thank you so much. Thank you for having me.
We were just looking at that video there, and just to see the precision and just how beautiful it all looks. Talk to us about the work that goes into preparing such a big season that you guys have coming up.
Yeah, it's amazing to work with a team of dancers who are so committed to excellence. And they work every day in ballet class and rehearsals to prepare lots of different kinds of ballets. Everything from what you would expect in pointe shoes and tutus to more contemporary works that are barefoot and even one ballet that can be performed in the living room.
That is awesome. And one of those that you were talking about, we have video of, is Todo Raba. It's a lighthearted, full ensemble work, simply as a thank you to God. Can you explain a little bit more about this piece we're seeing here?
Yeah, absolutely. So for me, I think my family and my faith are two huge parts of who I am. And so Todo Raba, it refers to this gift of gratitude that I wanted to share with the company and the audience, just as a memorial to the 10 years that we have spent creating this company.
That is amazing. And like you had mentioned, you know, a little bit about your faith there, but I feel like just about any piece that people will witness and get to see this season has a little bit of you behind it as well. Talk to us about the different pieces and just how you were able to bring yourself into just all those pieces of art.
Yeah, so I think for me, as a Mexican-American growing up, dance and music have been such a huge part of my culture. And I think ballet is actually kind of unusual for a Latina to get into ballet at a young age, at least for my generation. That was not the norm.
Sure.
But I was really fortunate to have a lot of people who believed in me and who facilitated my journey to become a professional ballet dancer. And so I think you see that part of me in all of the work. My goal and my heart is not to just put on ballets that speak to an elite minority of people, but to really make dance that is fun and lively and inclusive of all backgrounds.
And that work and dedication has definitely shown, and it's paying off, because this time around, this season, you guys even have a residency here in the area.
Yes, we're thrilled to be having the honor this year of being a resident company at the Harris Theater in Chicago. And I'm super grateful that they're supporting the work of the many different women that got me to where I am. And I hope that my work can inspire the next generation of minority women to keep going and to keep making ballet something that is their home and is something that is an important part of our cultural experience here in Chicago.
Absolutely. Another thing people will experience this season is just how the times have changed. And one of those things is with the Living Room series. Talk to us about that series.
Yeah, so the Living Room series actually was sparked by a story about my own grandparents. My grandma and grandpa Rubio are just an incredible inspiration to me. And they have a lot of stories that I heard growing up in their living room about kind of how they overcame many challenges and how they raised my dad and how the challenges of being second generation immigrants to America has shaped our family. So using that as a jumping off point, I'm also collecting other stories from the dancers, from some of our audience members, from friends of mine. And my goal is to really make this ballet something that is a custom curated experience that will speak to the lives that we live in our living room and how much we grow and change and relate to one another in that setting.
That's such a beautiful way of putting it. And now, this is just one of many beautiful arrays of creative works that people will be able to experience as we move up into the summer months as well. But I understand you guys are also going to be offering online performances and even going on tour.
Yeah, so we have this amazing group of people at Ballet 5-8 who are passionate about taking the art that we create and putting it on stage for as many people as possible. So accessibility is something we're hugely passionate about. And the online forum for dance is something that's really increased during the pandemic and maybe has been a silver lining for dance. that we've learned how to put our work online. So I'm excited that no matter where you're from, you can tune in and be a part of some of these experiences that are more than entertainment, that really speak to the heart and soul of who we are as humans.
That's amazing. Well, Juliana, is there anything else you'd like to add or you'd like people to know, maybe even where they can go to get more information and tickets?
Yeah, so one thing I'm super passionate about is giving space for more minority voices to put their art on stage. So this year, I'm so excited to be joined by Matthew Rushing of the Alvin Ailey American Dance Theater, and also Tobin James, who's a former dancer with the Martha Graham Dance Ensemble. So the two of them will be creating work on the company, and I cannot wait to see what they come up with. If you want more information about my work and the work of my co-creators, you can visit ballet58.org.
That's amazing. Juliana, thank you so much for joining us. We appreciate it, and we look forward to seeing your work out on the stage.
Thank you so much.